Back in my day, we had to write resumes and cover letters by this thing called a pen and paper.
Back in my day, we used ChatGPT.
All right, although I'm joking for the most part in that intro, there is some truth to it. We've come a long way very quickly, and as tech is moving so quickly, there are so many new tools that will really help make the job hunting process so much easier, land a better job, higher salary, and all that. And that's what we are going to cover today. Before we do though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, career-related videos, and any questions or other tools that you have, leave in the comments. Let's get into it.
Now, we're gonna start with a platform or an AI tool that does pretty much all the heavy lifting for you. I'm sure I'm not alone when saying when you are starting to craft a resume, a lot of times we end up just sitting there with this blinking cursor, staring at the screen for what feels like or maybe hours, not knowing where to start. That is where tools like the one I'm about to show you can really come in. I'm not saying get an AI to completely write your entire resume and then ship it off to companies, but what I do think this tool or tools like this can really do to help you is give you a starting point. So using this tool to start writing your resume or even do a rough draft of it, taking that and then modifying it yourself. This is great for anyone who has, what is it called? Writer's block. Writer's block isn't necessarily a writer to begin with. You know, you're applying for maybe a technical role or whatever role you're applying for, and you're just staring at the screen. Okay, let me share with you about this tool.
All right, you can see here on screen, I have Kick Resume up. And the first thing it's going to do after you sign up is ask you a series of questions. So right now we have, what's your name? It has to be the first question, Tiff. What was a recent job title? Software developer. And then you get to pick a template. So let me zoom in here. What template should we pick? I'm kind of gravitating towards the middle one. Let's pick the middle one here. But also too, as you saw at the bottom there, you could browse from other ones as well. AI robots at work. Better than me being at work. All right, so next up, you can see here, it literally will generate kind of a template for you. Also too, from there, you can, there are free aspects and then of course, premium aspects. But honestly, if you're job hunting and you need the help of setting up your resume, you can always sign up and then not sign up when you don't need it anymore. So we can see here, add new section. There are different sections to choose from. Graphs, references, skills, et cetera, et cetera. Personal information, you can start filling that out, adding a photo if you choose. I don't add photos when I have the resume. I don't know why, just not my thing. Curious to hear if you do though. Anyways, overall, this is a really great tool. You can see examples of other ones, especially others that are close to what you are applying for. These ones, software engineering team, software engineer. Yeah, so that's really helpful as well. This is for, I believe, an intern, but you still get the idea of what others have done for when they are applying to roles similar to you. Anyways, I linked all these tools down below. None of these are sponsored. I just wanted to share some really cool AI tools with you, and Kick Resume is definitely one of them.
All right, so now once we have our resume created with the help of AI, but then also too with our own human touch, we gotta still have the human touch there. It's time to start applying for jobs. And I know many of you are looking for remote jobs. I found this really cool AI tool that will help match you based on the remote jobs that are best suited for you. And the name of this tool is really cool, very suitable, I must say, for remote jobs. It's actually called Pajama Jobs. And all you need to do is upload your resume and it will sift through all the different online job platforms and match you with the ones it thinks is best. Let me show you.
All right, so you can see here on screen, this Pajama Jobs that I was speaking about is actually by the same company, Kick Resume. That's why it has its logo there. And that's how I discovered Pajama Jobs. So you don't need to use Kick Resume to build your resume in order to use Pajama Jobs to find your perfect remote job. But that's one way you can. And for me, for this example, because I built my resume with Kick Resume, you can simply upload it through Kick Resume to Pajama Jobs, if that makes sense. I'll link it down below. I think I made it sound more complicated than it needed to be. Anyways, once you are in Pajama Jobs, it will ask you a series of questions such as the salary you are looking for, how senior you are, where you are located, even though it's all remote jobs. Some remote jobs still want you to be located in a certain country. And for this example, here's what it spit out for me. So 87 remote jobs, and you can see here, if I scroll down, it says the salary, the range of mid to senior, full-time and all of that. So it's pretty interesting. It takes from all of these different job platforms, so you don't need to spend your time sifting through them. You can come here and start using them. Now, once again, like Kick Resume, it's free, and then there's an upgraded version. So this is just with the free version. That's probably all I would do, is just use the free version.
Have you been there when you are applying for jobs, but nothing seems to stick? Now, this might be due to the market, high competition, many different factors, but it also might be due to the fact that AI is rejecting your resume. Yes, you heard that right. A lot of times, especially at bigger companies, the first initial pass at your resume isn't a human, it's actually AI. It's looking for specific keywords throughout your resume. And if your resume, even if you are the perfect fit for this role, but it does not have these keywords specific to this job that you are applying for, you might miss out on it. That's where this tool comes in handy. It will actually scan your resume, give you a score, a percentage of how accurate your resume is or how likely it is to pass through the initial AI test, and from there, give you suggestions on how to modify it. This tool is called JobScan, and I've used it in the past before, and it's really, I love it. I think it's super user-friendly, and it gives really good tips about keywords you can implement. Let me show you.
All right, let's get into JobScan. I've spoke about JobScan in the past because it's actually a tool I used when I was job hunting. I think I shared this earlier, but I think it's a really great tool. So I'm not gonna go into the actual tool itself. You can upload your resume for free, and there are certain parts that you will get for free, but like anything, like any tool, there's always a paid version. They need to make money too. But you can definitely use the free version. That's all I did. You can sign up and scan your resume. So you can see here in their diagram though, what it will do is it will share with you the match rate, and this is based on the job or type of job you are looking for. And then also too, it will share with you different keywords to include, different kind of descriptions you can add, and then also too, it shares with you specifically in your resume areas that are weak and areas that are really good. So in this example, you can see here contact info, not so good, whereas education match is good. Now, I wanna do a little caveat here. Just because a tool is telling you something isn't good doesn't mean it's not good. Let's make that very clear here. AI is going based on logical data. It's not going on human ways of thinking. So the reality is, maybe AI doesn't think your education is a successful match, but it might be. Or maybe it's not a successful match, but that's okay. So don't get too caught up on these things. It's just a really great tool to help enhance you when you are job hunting.
Okay, I have a confession to make. One of the areas I am the most laziest in is cover letters. Actually, to be totally candid with you, about a year ago when I was applying to jobs, 99.9% of them asked for a cover letter. I don't think I did any cover letters, which is really bad. And this is why I'm confessing it to you, because we're friends. But it's true, honestly, I should have, and I probably would have, you know, seen faster job results or job searches or interview, whatever. It was a good process, knock on wood. But at the end of the day, cover letters are still really important and they are needed, and it really shows you went the extra mile when applying. The reason I didn't do it is because honestly, I detest the idea of having to write a cover letter. It just seems so, I get writer's block to the next level. Like I can't even think about writing a cover letter. It just sounds terrible. But it's so important and it really shows that you went the extra mile. So my biggest advice and what I would do if I was job hunting all over again is use this AI tool to write my cover letter for me. Then from there, once again, just like all these tools, I would modify it to with the human touch. This tool I'm talking about is called CoverDoc AI, and I'm going to share with you what it can do in a second here, but it promotes, and I think it's truly accurate in saying you can write cover letters up to 10 times faster, or in cases for people like me, 100 times faster.
All right, I have up on screen here CoverDoc AI, and as I mentioned, their whole mantra, one of it is you can write personalized cover letters 10 times faster, or as I already mentioned, 100 times faster if you are me. Let's watch this video here of the tool and kind of it in action, actually. All right, so we can see here, create a cover letter. And then from there, take what you want, the title you want, job title, company name. They're getting very specific. Let's see here, about the job. So you're literally taking the entire job description at this point, copying it and pasting it into the job description, which is really great how customizable it can get. All right, let's see the output here. Your cover letter request is in progress. You'll get an email of a draft, which you can then open up. It opens up in a Google Doc, and there is your cover letter. This is next level. It's so handy. I'm definitely going to use this in the future. It's just super user-friendly. You know, it says 20 minutes per cover letter. You can get started for free as well. This is just really great. I would highly recommend checking this out. It's something that you can use to varying degrees, but just to not have this writer's block and in turn not create a cover letter like I did.
You cleaned up your resume, you applied to many jobs, and now you got some really exciting interviews. You thought the hard part was the first part with writing the resume, applying to jobs. No. If you are anything like me, the most stressful part at the very least is the interview. Not even the interview, but it's leading up to the interview, I should say. It's the nerves, the anxiety, the fear of failure, especially when you are doing a technical interview. That is where tools that can really help you practice your interview skills, both soft skills and technical skills, are key. And of course, there are tools that we are all familiar with, especially from the technical side, such as LeetCode or different sites where you can practice algorithms. However, if you are looking for a tool to kind of interview you, if that makes sense, like it's a two-way conversation, I would highly suggest checking out this tool. It's called Interview Warmup, and it's actually by Google. And there are different roles that you can select that it will interview you for. Now, there are still some that are missing. I think there's a lot of key roles, but still a ton of key roles that are missing from this tool. So what I would do, if your role isn't there, select something that's similar, because at the beginning of these interview warmups, these tools, or this tool that it interviews you with, it's a lot of personable questions, which I think especially if you are applying for a technical role, we often kind of push off the soft skill side and focus so much on preparing for the technical side of the interview, which is key, of course, but you also need to put some thought and prepare to the soft skill side. Because if they are interviewing you and for these questions you didn't prepare on the soft skill side, you start freezing up, they're gonna be like, well, yeah, they're a great coder, but they don't have communication skills. They don't have team skills. So this is a great tool for you. Let me show you.
All right, this tool by Google, as I mentioned, Interview Warmup, I've used in the past, and it just even helps take me from psyching myself out. Do you know what I mean? Like being able to practice the interview and just feel more confident going into it, if anything. So you can see here, let's go into start practicing. And then from there, you can say, what field do you want to practice for? So we have data analytics, e-commerce, IT, project management, UX, cybersecurity, general. So once again, if your role or your field is not here, you can always go to general. Answer 5 interview questions. You can start. Hi.
Hi, let's practice an interview. What are you looking for in your next job?
Okay, I can't do this right now. Don't listen to me. Oh no, it's gonna answer. Okay. Yeah, you can literally speak to it. So what are you looking for in your next job? You can click on answer with the microphone and speak back. This is so key. I know it sounds so silly, but the more you practice speaking your answers out loud, the better you will be during the interview process. I can guarantee this. This is a free tool by Google, Interview Warmup. Go check it out.
All right, I hope you found this video useful and helpful and hopefully picked up some tips or tools that you can use for the next time you are job hunting. AI doesn't have to be this big scary thing that we put off using because we think that it's going to take over our jobs or it's not as good. You can use it for snippets of your everyday life, such as job hunting, and still add your personal touch, your human touch to it. All right, once again, leave any questions or comments you have down below, and I'll see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.